Buesching mastodon. What we've been doing recently is learning more about the life of this animal, details about his adolescence, and also what happened later in his life when he became a fully mature male and began to mate. We never knew before that mastodons had migratory behavior, his land use, seasonally and year by year, how he moved across the landscape, what parts of the landscape he considered home. Probably one of the most significant findings is that mastodons showed a regular annual mating behavior. They traveled. Mastodons are relatives of elephants, not especially close relatives of elephants. Mammoths are much closer, but mastodons are more distant relatives of elephants. Male mastodons got into huge battles. The Buesching animal actually died in one of those battles. And an important point that we haven't quite captured yet is that all of that history is captured, is recorded in the structure and composition of the tusk. But in addition to daily layers, there are layers that are about 2 weeks in duration, and there are layers that are annual layers. To study this tusk, we first had to cut the tusk down the middle, and the parts that we chose were times when we could see that there was variation in growth rates. Times are good, times are bad, whatever it is, it's changing.
So after those tusk slabs have been cut and polished, we can sample them incrementally for both strontium isotopes and oxygen isotopes. And then the trick is matching those values of strontium isotopes to the landscape. Each value is basically a little geographic fingerprint. What my role is, translating that fingerprint to an actual landscape use. So we've uncovered all this really interesting information about the Buesching mastodon. 12,000 years ago, mastodons, mammoths, giant sloths, those are the animals that define places around the University of Michigan, the University of Cincinnati. The bones are those records. So one of the core next steps is to understand whether this mating ground that the Buesching mastodon visited year after year, was that a regional mating ground? Was it something much more local? Those are big questions we have yet to answer. Today, using new geochemical techniques and models, we can show that mastodons like the Buesching mastodon migrated every year to the mating grounds.